I put out an Addicts Editions episode yesterday, and as soon as that goes out, we make another sign-in. A typical Charlton, always leaving it late. Hello, everybody, and welcome back to another episode of Addicts Editions. Monday, we complete the signing of Pape Soare, and after I uploaded the video about him yesterday, literally probably an hour or so after that, Charlton brought in the final piece to the puzzle to complete our squad and set us on our way for 2021-22, and it's another Nigel.
Just banter.
But it's a familiar face. Charlton Athletic have completed the permanent signing of Crystal Palace shot stopper Stephen Henderson. He is back in SE7. His longly awaited return to the Valley is finally here. He has signed a 1-year deal for the club, and yeah, that is it. That is our squad pretty much there now, near enough completed. Every single position is now full with depth. We sort of needed a second choice goalkeeper to be behind McGillivray, obviously Nathan Harness being our backup at the moment, and we've managed to get that man in, and I am very, very happy to see Stephen come back to the football club as another option in between the posts. So as ever, with these videos, you guys know how they go now. We will go through the club's article, talk about what Stephen and Thomas Sandgaard have to say about this move, and then we will get into my thoughts about the signing. So kicking things off with the club's article. Charlton Athletic are delighted to confirm the permanent signing of former Addick Stephen Henderson. The popular goalkeeper played 54 games for Charlton between 2014 and 2016. He becomes the Addicks' 13th signing of the summer after Senegal international left-back Pape Soare signed for Charlton on Monday. The 33-year-old has been training with the club for the last 5 weeks and signed a 1-year contract. He said, "It feels really good to be back. It's a great atmosphere, good staff. There are really positive vibes, and I'm just really blessed that I've been given another opportunity at such a great club." Owner Thomas Sandgaard said, "It has been a busy summer and I'm pleased we've been able to bring in another goalkeeper into the squad. Stephen has been training with the club for a while now and our staff have been impressed with what they have seen, so I am very pleased to have him back at Charlton." Born in Dublin, Henderson began his career at Belvedere before joining Aston Villa in 2005. He signed for Bristol City in 2007, where he played 5 championship games and enjoyed permanent spells at Portsmouth and West Ham United before joining the Addicks in 2014. After leaving Charlton, he joined Nottingham Forest before signing for Crystal Palace in 2019. I think that genuinely might be the first article I've read without making a single error or mistake. So there is the club's article about the signing. Now it's time to get into my thoughts about Stephen Henderson making his return to the club. Now, this has been on the cards for a very long time now. Obviously, when it was first revealed by the South London Press that Henderson was training with the club, I sort of thought that, yeah, we're going to get this guy in. And while it did drag out a little bit, it did take some time for us to complete the move. Obviously, as the club said, Henderson has been training with us for the past 5 weeks. We have managed to get the deal done. Now, Henderson, of course, did used to play for Charlton back in 2014 to 2016 during our championship campaign. And he was quite the fan favourite, it has to be said. I must say, he was one of my favourite players during this time. You know, a very solid, consistent performer at championship level. He kept 100% penalty record in 2014-15, albeit he saved only 2 penalties, but nevertheless, it's still 100% record, so I'm going to count it either way. And then in 2015-16, I mean, obviously, it was just an absolute nightmare of a season for the club in general, and the Roland situation and the club getting relegated. He did end up leaving Charlton when we got relegated, and of course, he joined Nottingham Forest, which you could definitely say was the wrong move for him at the time when he left us. Many Charlton fans have said that, oh, he should never have left us. And to be fair, if you look at his career, you kind of have to say that that is true, because when he joined Nottingham Forest, from what I can gather, he only played 12 times for them in the league in 3 seasons that he was there. So not a lot of game time at all. And he had loan spells at Portsmouth and Wycombe Wanderers during that time as well. Pompey in 2017-18, where he played just once in League One. And then in 2018-19, he went to Wycombe, the season Charlton got promoted back to the Championship, and he played only 3 times in League One. So his game time was very much limited. And then, of course, after when he was released from Nottingham Forest, he then made the move to Crystal Palace to become their third choice goalkeeper behind Wayne Hennessy and Vicente Guaita. And loads of Premier League clubs end up having third choice keeper now. I mean, look at that Lee Grant from Manchester United. But that is the concern with me for this signing, Henderson coming back, because he actually never played any football whatsoever for Crystal Palace in competitive competition. So that does mean that Henderson has not played a single minute of professional football in a professional game, whether that be league or cup competitions. He has never played a game since the 2018-19 season with Wickham. So he's nearly gone 3 seasons without making a professional appearance. So with that, you can absolutely say that Henderson is coming in as our backup option, our alternative to Craig McGillivray. And I knew that straight away. As soon as he was going to be training with us, I sat there thinking, yeah, Craig should be still number one ahead of him. No, don't get me wrong, Henderson is a very good goalkeeper. As I say, 33 years of age, brings a lot of experience to the side. Obviously, used to play for Charlton, so he knows the club well. And he will be a very useful player to have, because obviously we needed a second choice keeper. Obviously, with Maynard Brewer going out on loan, with Nathan Harness coming in. He's never played a game in League One before, or any league competition for that matter. So I guess you could say we needed a bit more stability in between the sticks and for our cover. And we've got that in Henderson. Obviously, his lack of game time over the years is a worry. But he was always going to come in as cover. And the truth is, he's going to be very good cover. That is the main positive that I can take out of this sign. And I can take a number of positives out of it, as I mentioned before. Obviously, there is the negative with the lack of games recently or over the last couple of years. But regardless, he is coming in as our backup option to McGillivray. And I'm very happy with it. I'm very, very happy that we've got him on board as our alternative. And I think that obviously he's had 5 weeks of training now. So obviously he's keeping fit. He's keeping sharp. And who knows, he could actually challenge McGillivray. McGillivray needed that bit of a nudge, you know. I don't think Harness was really going to challenge him much. And after McGillivray's shaky starts of the season in the Wigan and Crewe game, since then though, since with those 2 games, he has improved. But he did have quite a rocky start to the season. So I think he needed that just a little bit more pressure. And I think Henderson will provide that in abundance. And I think that we have done very, very well again to get this guy in on a free transfer and on a 1-year contract. I think we've done very well with this one. And I am, as I say, very happy to see Henderson back in a Charlton shirt. Very, very happy. And hopefully he can get some minutes under his belt this season. So that is it, guys, for another episode of Addicts Editions. I hope you guys did enjoy it. If you did, can you possibly leave a like, subscribe if you're new around here, and turn on this post notification so you are notified of every time I post a new video. Welcome back to Charlton, Stephen Henderson. All the pieces of the puzzle have now been merged together, and we have got a pretty decent squad on paper. And honestly, bring on the season, man. Bring on the season. Cannot wait for our game on Saturday. It's a daily upload of Addicts Editions today, but don't get used to it. Daily uploads probably won't continue that often, maybe for quite a while. But I asked you guys if you wanted to see an episode of Henderson today, and you guys wanted to see it, so I thought I may as well give you what you want and give you a video today. So I hope you guys did enjoy this video. Welcome back to Charlton, Stephen Henderson. This has been Tyler Rowlinson. Have a nice day, and I will see you all in the next video later this weekend. Take it easy, stay safe, and I'll see you all then.